I think it's been years since we've done this walk followed by breakfast tradition. Definitely not in the last year and a half.
I think that's the beautiful thing about Bengaluru, right? I mean, in the heart of the city, you have this 200 plus acre park.
But Shri has never tasted.
Yeah, I have not.
A Brahmin's coffee bar idli.
I mean, no.
Ah, one double for lega.
Hi, folks. It's a beautiful Bengaluru morning, and we decided to step out. Step out.
For breakfast.
But we said before we do breakfast, we should earn that breakfast. So we've decided to go for a bit of a walk. And this is something that we haven't done in a long time.
Yeah, very long time.
I think it's been years since we've done this walk followed by breakfast tradition. Definitely not in the last year and a half. Now the weather is beautiful, cloudy, and we thought it's perfect to step out for a bit of a walk. Although it's a little late in the morning than we typically would have stepped out, but this was a impromptu last minute sort of a decision, and sometimes they work out best. Traffic is slowly but surely building up back in Bengaluru. So are you looking forward to the walk or are you looking forward to breakfast?
Both. Nice long brisk walk for about 30-40 minutes followed by breakfast so that you don't feel guilty.
The breakfast that we do today will not be the one that will induce pangs of guilt. I think it's going to be a rather healthy sort of a breakfast. I don't want to reveal where we are going now. Of course, you've seen it already in the title. I don't know what's open, what's not open. Even the place that we're going for a walk, I'm not sure if it's open yet. So I guess we will get there and find out. ಇಲ್ಲ ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ವಾಕಿಂಗ್
ನೂರು ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ
ಮುಂಚೆ ಇದು ನಾವು ಒಳಗೆ ನಡೆಯುವಾಗ ಹಣ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ
ಒಂಬತ್ತು ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್
ಓ ಒಂಬತ್ತು ಗಂಟೆ ಮುಂಚೆ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಫ್ರೀ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು ವೆಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಟ್ ಲಾಲ್ ಬಾಗ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 9 o'clock ಅಂಡ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ವೆರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಪೇ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಲಾಲ್ ಬಾಗ್ ಸೊ ಅಪ್ಯಾರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ 9 a.m. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಂಟ್ ನೋ ಇನ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 9 ಯು ಪೇ ಎನ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಫೀ 30 rupees ನಾಟ್ ಮಚ್ to get in and walk and soak in the fresh air at Lal Bagh.
We used to live in Jainagar. We used to come, you know, like at least couple of days a week in the morning. After shifting to Koramangala, I think last 8 years.
We've come in the middle, but yeah, we've not really...
Not that often.
Yeah. I think that's the beautiful thing about Bengaluru, right? I mean, in the heart of the city, you have this 200 plus acre park. It's an eagle. We're coming here after ages, so we're noticing things that we probably didn't notice earlier. Shri, Shri's found a fruit shop there and that's where she's headed. That's the thing with Shri. She finds these fruit shops, vegetable vendors. She wants to know what's happening. Are we here for a walk or shopping? Okay, you keep whatever you want aside.
Take a break like this and then, you know, come out for a walk in this nature, right?
Yeah.
And maybe have a nice healthy breakfast like some idli. Only in Bangalore you can afford to walk 10 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And it still won't feel hot or humid.
That is Nama Bengaluru. That of course is a glass house, which is where the Republic Day and the Independence Day flower shows happen. If you're in Bengaluru around that time, it's a must come and take a look, right?
Yeah.
I think this is a perfect place to take advantage of the glorious Bengaluru weather. Walk under the canopy of these ancient trees, huh?
Yeah. Some of them are 200 years old.
More than that, because I think the park itself, I think, was first established over 2.5 centuries ago. Lal Bagh. I was just reading up on it, and so Bagh, of course, is garden. Lal, they say, is either a reference to the color of the flowers, then lal or red, or lal also means deer.
Yeah.
Someone who's deer, you call them a lal, I suppose. This bagh came up 250 years ago, I think, during Hyder Ali's time, if I'm not mistaken. And then it was further developed during Tipu Sultan's time. And then, of course, the British and then the Maharaja. It's amazing that something that was set up 250 years ago is serving this beautiful, much needed purpose in today's day and age. It's fascinating. As you walk in this park now, listening to the chirp of the birds, watching the squirrels scurry around, you can almost forget that you're in the midst of a pandemic, right? Lotus pond. I don't think I've ever seen lotus in this pond.
Yeah. Many years ago, I'm sure, you know.
Originally, they probably had lotuses and lilies in here, but now it's just an expanse of water. It's amazing the numerous bird calls, no, that you hear.
Yeah.
I think if you're a bird watcher or an ornithologist, I suppose you will know about the various species that exist, or the number of species that exist in these gardens. If you do have an idea, do post a comment below.
We used to sit on these benches sometimes, you know.
After the walk, when we were tired.
Right.
So this is our usual route, or actually the route that we would do earlier. We would take a couple of rounds around this lake and then
go in and around, you know?
Go in and around just to top up that walk, because it would get sunny here, there's no shade. And that's what our Lal Bagh walk was all about.
And the best part is, you know, when you walk here, you don't even know how much you're walking, because you'll be, you know, surrounded by the trees and, you know, like there's so many things to, you know, look at. So actually,
yeah,
you don't really know that you've walked for 40-50 minutes. Whereas when you walk in small parks, you know, like 4 rounds, 5 rounds, like that, you know, you will be counting. Whereas here, you just don't realize how much you walked.
Yeah.
And it's so therapeutic, you know. The greenery is like that, no? It's very good for your eyes. Anything you look at, green.
I think this is fantastic, just walking by the lake.
I'm so glad we did this today. I think once in a while, you know, the day you skip your bike ride, I think we should just come for it.
Of course, now with the curfews, I can't step out on weekends. But let's say if I'm doing my motorcycle ride on Sundays, we can do this some other day of the week. It doesn't, so I can still do my motorcycle ride, and we can do this walk as well. What do you say?
But once everything gets opened up, I don't think you will have time to take it easy like this.
No, I think we should.
One thing that one has learned from this situation or the pandemic is that I think you have to take it a little easy as well and do what you can. Enjoy small pleasures, right? So for instance, you cannot really travel much now without thinking too much. But when you travel, what do you want to do? You want to basically take a break, right? Of course, it's nice to travel, to go beyond the city, to see other states and all of that. But I think travel is also about giving your mind some break, right? You know, and even if that break is just for an hour.
Yeah.
And I think that's where something like this helps. You know, the fact that you can just drive 5 kilometers from home, find a spot like this, an oasis like this, and just relax, unwind, take in, soak in the sounds of nature, the breeze, the wind,
In fact, I don't know what the sound is like because there's definitely the wind that's blowing right now. So apologies if you have some of the wind noise in the audio. But yes, I think that's what it's all about. I think that's why in Bengaluru, I think we're really blessed that we have access to parks all over. Of course, Lal Bagh, Kabban Park are the big parks. But I think every area, you'll have parks that you can just step out of your home, find a park, find a little piece of greenery and just take a break.
5-6 rounds like that, you know.
I think it's a pity that we have to wear this mask.
Yes.
So unless you really have to, I think it's advisable to keep the mask on.
Absolutely no one, so much space.
So. Yes, so Shri is the more practical one always. I'm the one who says, okay, let's keep on the right side of things. I mean, not that she does anything illegal, but lest you think otherwise.
Just in the morning, when we decided, I just said, do it.
Yeah, sometimes you keep planning, okay, ho gana. It never happens. But when you feel like it's okay, fine, and it's doable, it doesn't really need you to do much. You just kind of say, okay, let's do it. Get ready, get into the car, and here we are. I'll do that Shah Rukh Khan pose there. Shri, your outfit matches with those flowers.
The one full round around the lake, it's about 40 to 44 minutes.
So that's roughly how many kilometers?
About 3.3 kilometers, 3.4.
Around this lake?
Yeah.
I was saying that if you need to get your breakfast,
yes,
we need to leave now.
Take left here, You see some rose garden and all that stuff. If you want to even spend 2-3 hours also, aramse you can spend, get some, you know, shop eats, sit, eat.
Get some food.
Yeah.
Kalsas, are these new?
Yeah, I think so.
I've not noticed them.
Wait, I think it's new. I have not seen
it. This came up in 2018. I don't think we've seen it. And that's sitting under a mango tree that is 250 years old. Incredible. That's an interesting way of drawing people's attention to the trees. So you're bound to look at that giant chameleon. And that chameleon has a board that talks about the tree under whose canopy it's resting. And similarly here, this is a wooden log peacock which was installed in 2018. I don't know if you can see the plaque on it, and that's sitting under a Nilgiri tree which is over 200 years old. Fantastic. That's a great idea. Kudos to the chaps at Lal Bagh. Okay. How much
is
it?
120. How much is it?
110.
This is
jamun.
Ripe or ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Okay, thank you. Today I also did intermittent fasting.
Well, we are done with our walk here at Lal Bagh and we are off to breakfast. Shri also has inadvertently done some intermittent fasting today. It's 11 o'clock. As for me, I'm going to break my intermittent fast a bit earlier than usual today. Courtesy this walk at Lal Bagh. And the plan for breakfast is to go to this place called Brahmin's Coffee Bar. and savor their idlis. Now you've seen episodes on Brahmin's Coffee Bar on Gourmet on the Road, but Shri has never tasted.
Yeah, I have not.
A Brahmin's Coffee Bar idli. And so we are hoping to get to Brahmin's Coffee Bar and get Shri to taste her first. For those of you who know, who are familiar, it's probably one of the most popular idlis here in Bengaluru. I think when you talk of idli, the first idli that people talk about is the Brahmin's Coffee Bar idli. It's also been around for many decades.
I hope it is open. Sometimes Kabban Park walk and all that.
Kabban Park walk was the airline's butter masala dosa.
Yeah.
I think we should probably do that also one of these days. Do a walk to Kabban Park.
Then we should start early though.
We should start early there. Followed by the
breakfast.
Butter masala dosa breakfast.
Yeah.
So the Murugan idli, shop idli. So did you like that idli?
Yeah, I liked the idli. It was good.
Right, that's the Tamil Nadu style idli.
Okay.
Whereas this is a Bengaluru idli.
Okay.
Right, so in the Tamil Nadu style idli, they grind the rice, no?
Right.
They grind the rice, the urad dal and all of that.
Right.
Whereas here, it's the uddana bele and the rice rava, as they call it. There's a term, there's a Kannada term that they use for it. Akki tari.
Akki tari.
Yeah, so it's basically rice rava, so that they wash that about 3-4 times. And then, once the uddana bele is ground, fermented, just about half an hour before steaming the idli, they mix the akki tari in that. And that's the style of idli that you're going to taste. Excited?
Yeah, interesting. Let's see.
Well, I've done all this setup on this idli. I only hope we get some idli because things have just begun opening up. I know that Brahmin's Coffee Bar was only in takeaway mode. I hope they have begun serving idlis there. Otherwise, we've set the mood for the boss to taste some idli. If we don't get it, I don't think she'll be very happy.
No, I'm okay. Otherwise, we'll go somewhere else.
We'll go somewhere else. All right. You can eat both idli and vade. Namaskara. Ege dira. Eradu plate idli vade kodi.
Okay. Bende beka.
Bende beda. Amelu eradu coffee token kodi. Ishta idu. Thank you.
Ah, vande double barli ega.
How's the idli?
Excellent. It's just melting in your mouth. It's melting in your mouth.
That's the sort of idli this is.
Very good.
So this is Shri's first taste of the Brahmin's Coffee Bar idli.
Yeah.
I'm stuck with the idli plate in my hand because I got the camera in the other hand. So all that I can do is watch Shri savor her idli. No, that's okay. How will you taste the vade? How's the vade? Hot, cold?
Medium.
Medium. We're also coming closer to closing time. So they probably have fried their batch of vade for the day.
Managed to find a table somewhere around here. Time to savor my idli vade. That idli is a sort that dissolves in your mouth. Now, you don't need teeth to eat this idli.
Yeah.
Shri is also taking good work of the idli is over, now the vade is almost over. How's the vade?
Very tasty.
Yeah. So what do you think of, so you've never tasted Brahmin's Coffee Bar idli before. So how do you rate it?
Very good. On a scale of 10, 9.
Not 10.
9.
But for me, this is probably the best idli in Bengaluru. And that chutney, it's called urugadle, the green chili. There's some tamarind that goes in, so it gives it a bit of tartness. That's a delicious idli. The vade too has its
crunch. It's very tasty.
Yeah.
But only thing is, it wasn't not very hot, but
it's warm. It's a little more than warm. I love the crunch of that vade. The chutney is delicious. Huh? Did you get a repeat of the chutney?
Yeah.
I'm going to get it. Chutney of the rum. Thank you. Got some more chutney to soak up that idli. Shree's background, she's half Tamil and half Andhra. So I think her affinity is towards that Tamil style of idli.
No, no, even this is good.
Huh.
What I'm saying is, you know, like, it's very good, but just that I'm not, rating 10 on 10. That's about it. So 9 is also a very good rating.
9 is also a very good rating, because when it comes to Shree, she's quite sparing when it comes to rating food.
It's not like that. I feel, you know, like, the vada is 10 on 10.
Vada is 10 on 10.
Like the
taste,
the little bit of the coconut
there. I think there's also some Mesopotamia in the vada.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah,
green chili. Green chili, you can see the green chili right there. And this is a vada that has a delicious crunch. I'm shooting on the GoPro, so I don't think you can hear the crunch. With all the traffic around us, and then the crunch of the coconut, of the thai. This place has been around since 1965. So that's how many years?
56 years.
56 years serving only 4 dishes. Imagine the kind of confidence you need to have in the food that you serve. Where you say, I'm only going to do these 4 dishes. And look at it, we're now nearing closing time. Of course, there's no, you cannot stand in there and eat. You got to come out and eat. But people are all around us. If you want to catch the detailed Brahmin's Coffee Bar video, I'm going to place a link in the description below and also somewhere up here. I think the boss is standing here waiting for coffee and a bit impatient too. One the regular kodi, one the sakre kodi.
This coffee is 10 on 10.
Yeah. Best coffee.
Good. Wakes you up.
Wakes you up. Reinvigorates you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even the idli vade, I mean, it's a sort of breakfast that's very light.
Yeah.
Right? So you've eaten 2 idlis, 1 vade. You feel absolutely light after eating it. You know, there's.
Perfect. Next couple of hours, you don't have to work. When is your next meal?
I think I'll do my next meal.
Much for all in the evening.
Yeah, the only thing is today, maybe I'll do an early sort of a dinner. So then I'll still keep my intermittent on. You may have had a tough day, a long walk, but you have some of this coffee, just kind of.
Yeah.
Reinvigorates you, it wakes you up, this coffee. And I think that's why this whole concept of doing a tiffin after the walk is so popular, right?
Yeah. So especially in Bangalore.
Yeah. So people will walk maybe for an hour, but then they will come and do their idli, vade, dosa.
A lot of people, I remember many years ago, people would walk in Lal Bagh and they would go to MTR and have coffee. Or dosa, whatever they would have walked out, and the calories would have, you know, like, and then Kabban Park they go, and then they go to airlines for, you know, tiffin. So that way, you know, it's a tradition, you know, even we used to do that, right?
So it's an enjoyable way of putting those calories back. But there's a sense of satisfaction that you get. You know, you have walked for an hour, and then when you go for that idli vada, you don't feel... But typically you wouldn't eat the vada, you would...
No, I wouldn't eat the vada, because today, you know, I think I did my yoga also in the morning before coming, and again walk up for 3.5 kilometers, so I said, I deserve to. I have earned it.
You earned it. So that's exactly the point. So I think when people go for a walk, and then they stop for the tindi, they feel they've earned it.
Yeah.
Right? So somebody who's looking at them, who's watching, saying, hey, you know what, you've just gone for a walk and you're now eating all of that. But for those who've gone through that walk, they have earned it. Like, we have that idli vade and this coffee.
Well, that was a midweek morning expedition to Lal Bagh Botanical Gardens and also Shree's first breakfast at Brahmin's Coffee Bar.
Oh, it was very good. The idli was good and even the vade was good. Coffee was superb. Yeah. It's a good experience.
If you haven't caught the Brahmin's Coffee Bar video on the main channel, do look it up, where we've done an in-depth review of the offerings there, including the Kara Bath and Kesari Bath too. So I think that's it for this vlog. Hope you enjoyed it. Take care, stay safe, stay strong. And try to do those little things that make you happy. Whether it's a short walk in the park or perhaps a hobby or a recreation that you haven't gotten to in a while. I think we all need
these little pleasures.
I think we all need these little pleasures to keep us happy in these challenging times. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.